What is up, guys? Welcome back to the channel. In this video, we'll check this new Foam Cannon PRO from MJJC. I am using right now an old foam cannon, also from MJJC. If you didn't saw that review video, I will add the link in the description below. So today I'm really curious to see how the new foam cannon will perform. From specification, it should have 30% thicker foam, but let's check it. So let's open the box. This is the first time also for me. So this is how it comes. We get the bottle, which I will explain later, but I already see some improvements here. And some specs, I think. I will read this before I use it. Let's put this aside. What do we have here? I already see improvements comparing it to the older foam. I will show it to you in a minute. So, what do we get in the package? So we get the bottle, which is 1.2 liters. It has a grading until 1 liter, but it can contain up to 1.2 liters of solution, of course. Then we get the nozzle itself, which is way different than the older one with the MJJC logo here. To be honest, it looks quite premium. Everything feels high quality. And here we have the adapter to your pressure washer. Mine is for a Karcher or Karcher, I don't know how you call it. And here it's a nozzle, which I think, based on the older foam lines that I used, this has a smaller hole, and this should be used with the pressure washers, which are not so powerful, like mine. I have a Karcher K2, and this is the solution collector. So MJJC is mentioning that you don't necessarily need to replace this, but in case you want to, you need to make sure that your pressure washer has between 90 and 110 bars. Mine has 110 and I will replace it. So you only need a flathead screwdriver. You just unscrew the nozzle which is inside. Then let's place the new one in. Hand tight. Let's install the collector. You just press it in. A very interesting improvement, I would say, from the older lens. You see that this adapter for your pressure washer now comes with a nice connection, which also has a rubber sealing, so you don't need to use Teflon or something else in order to prevent water from or pressure to leak here. But this one, it's really, really nice. And also, by doing so, you can arrange the position of the adapter based on your gun, which you have from the pressure washer. And let's assemble it to the bottle. One good thing that you will notice immediately is that this collector always stays in the lowest side of the bottle. So this is good when you need to incline the lens and so on. You will always get the solution, even if you are running out, let's say. The first improvement which I saw comparing it to the old lens, let me grab the older one. So this is the old lens. The first improvement you see is the diameter of the bottle. This one being so small, it becomes very unstable, let's say. Don't get me wrong, this is a very good snow foam lens, a very good value for the money, but it has some flaws, and it seems that this is a much better one. So as you can see, this one is so unstable, this one is really, really stable because of this bigger base. Another improvement which I saw is that for the old one, you have this very, very small bottle opening. So this makes it harder for you to fill water or solution inside. This one has a very big one, which is good. And another one is that for the older lens, you see this one is metal, this one is plastic. When you screw them, you have to be really careful not to destroy the thread on the bottle. And on the new one, you will see that both of them are plastic. Also, they are very big, and this makes it very, very easy for you to thread it in. Of course, you will not do it this way because the bottle will be full. You will do it something like this, and works like a charm. Another improvement I see, and I compare it with the older one, is that for the older one, you only have the possibility to change the opening of the nozzle, which is, let's say, changing the pattern of the snow foam jet, let's say. But with the newer one, let's take this out. Not only that you change the opening of the nozzle, but you can also rotate it. I hope you can see it. This is horizontal, let's say. Now this is vertical. This is really nice because sometimes with the older one, I felt the need to, let's say, incline the lens like this. But of course, if you don't have really, if you don't have enough solution, then you will pick only air. As for the older one, we have here a screw which allows us to correct or to change the amount of solution which is picked up by the lens while pressure washing your car. So you can make the foam being thicker or thinner. I always use the thickest setting. It's not best to have the thickest foam, but I just like it. Okay, so that being said, this is how it looks coming out from the box. Let's test it now. Alright guys, so let's mix the solution. We'll use the same active foam that we used last time, which is specified to have a dilution of 1 to 1 up to 1 to 4. We will add 1 to 2. So let's add 200 milliliters of active foam and then 400 milliliters of water. I will add warm water because I know that warm water helps having a thicker foam. As you can see, the car is really dusty. So let's see how this foam cannon will behave. So we have 200 milliliters of active foam. Let's now add the warm water. Water it's in, we have in total 600 milliliters, so let's install the Karcher and then let's see how it behaves. Take you closer. Let's make another try.
first, try not to wash your car in the sun. It's hard not to leave some stains. Second, try not to wash it in wind. You will get wet.
What do I think about the foam cannon? Well, I really like it. It's stable. It's more practical. The foam is really nice and really sticky. One thing I observed is that compared to the old one, the consumption of the solution is slightly higher. But also, what I did is an overkill for this. So having a dilution of 1 to 2, even if with a cheap solution like I have, it's an overkill. You can easily go for 1 to 4 or 1 to 6. Also, I tried to reduce it from this adjusting knob, and I think I went halfway and the foam was almost not changed, so thick enough. So you can just play with this one and make it as you like it. So yeah, I really like it. I'll use it from now on. I will replace the old one which I had, and looking forward to see other products from MJJC.
So if you have any suggestions or questions, please address them in the comment box below. I hope this video helps you, and if it does, you can give a like to the video. Also, if you want to support the channel, you can subscribe and turn on the notifications so you'll be notified when I make videos like this one. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.